Hey everybody, I'm Linux Gamer. With GDC just around the corner and the official release of SteamOS imminent, I thought it would be fun to take a moment and look at what Valve are doing. Maybe come up with a list of features I'd like to see of SteamOS. So that's what I'm gonna do. Here are my top 5 plus 1 features I'd like to see in SteamOS.
At number 5, I'd like to see Twitch.tv streaming integrated. I know that Valve are beta testing their own in-house live streaming feature, but there should be a way to simultaneously stream to Twitch in the interface. I probably don't need to tell you this, but audiences on Twitch are much larger than they are on Steam. However, they may not want to do this for a number of reasons. For example, if they're trying to compete with Twitch. So if they don't enable Twitch streaming, I'd at least like to see easier discovery of live streams from people I'm not friends with. Which brings me to my next point.
The Steam community exists, but I think Valve could be doing more to drive interaction between friends and strangers through their platform. I know some people will disagree with me, but I'd like to see a Twitter-style or Facebook-like feed featuring recent friend activity, activity from popular users and curators, upcoming and recent events, news from games that you play the most, and activity from users you've recently played online with. There's already a feed kind of like what I'm talking about, but it's not particularly engaging. Plus, it lacks some of the information I mentioned, and thus, I hardly ever look at it. There's something that I just don't like about the way Steam sorts music. I'd like to see a media tab separating my games and music, because as it stands right now, it just doesn't suit my needs. Plus, the music sorting reminds me of Windows Media Center, and nobody wants to be reminded of that atrocity. Also, Netflix on Linux is serviceable through Chrome as a desktop application, but what we need is a controller-friendly interface for the streaming service. The same goes for other services like Spotify, iHeartRadio, Amazon Prime Video, Hulu, and others. I'd like to see controller-friendly clients for all of these services and more in SteamOS. And I know that Steam controllers will be able to act like trackpads and enable cursor control, but that, in my opinion, is not really consumer-friendly. The reason we all love PC gaming is because of the freedom it affords. In keeping with such openness, the settings menu in Steam Big Picture Mode, as it stands, is great, but there's definitely room for more. We need more customizability. We need more options, more granular control of what shows up in the store and on which platforms. Maybe even color schemes or skins for Big Picture Mode. More modularity. More settings. More, I say! Valve should lay out a standard of quality, and all games that conform to that standard should get a badge prominently featured on their store page. For example, to get the Steam Standard badge, the game would have to be fully compatible with SDL2 controller configurations. The game would be playable from start to finish with any controller without the need for a mouse and keyboard. The game would be optimized to run in Big Picture mode, and the use of Big Picture's overlay doesn't slow down minimum spec machines. The game would require no startup configuration, and the game would have no external launcher utility that doesn't accept controller input. There's obviously room for debate, and I welcome anyone's input on this standard. Now, games wouldn't be required to conform to these standards, but doing so would reward the developers with a badge. Kind of like a Nintendo seal of quality, though that might not be the best example. While not a feature, I'd like to see platform exclusives on SteamOS. Valve has said on multiple occasions that they don't want platform exclusives. Greg Coomer of Valve says, "You won't see an exclusive killer app for SteamOS from us. We're not gonna do that kind of thing." Some people breathe a sigh of relief when they hear that. I don't. While the ethics of the company may prohibit such behavior, I believe Half-Life 3 or one of their other AAA titles should at least be a timed exclusive. The thing about exclusives is that big names drive platform adoption. If the only way you could play Half-Life 3, Left 4 Dead 3, or Portal 3 was through SteamOS, I'm sure many people would get a Steam machine, even if it only had 3 months of exclusivity. Luckily, though Valve seemed to have pledged to not make exclusive first-party titles, that doesn't mean other developers aren't allowed to. Whether the people at Valve agree with my ideas or not, I think SteamOS is poised to take over the living room, and knowing Gabe and the team have the consumers in mind is very comforting. So that's my opinion. What do you think? What would you like to see from SteamOS? Leave a comment down below or tweet at me on Twitter @TheLinuxGamer. You can also join the Linux Gamer group on Steam and subscribe to my curator page. Links to all the socials are in the description below. Feel free to check out the rest of my channel, including my previous Olly Olly review. If you like this video, hit that like button, share it with your friends, and be sure to subscribe to see more from me, the Linux Gamer. Thanks for watching!